In today's video, I show you how selection sort works and how to determine its time complexity without mathematical derivations, but with a playing card example with animations and visualizations. Let's get started. Selection sort can basically also be shown with playing cards, as in the last example with insertion sort. I don't know anyone who picks up their cards the way I'm about to show you, but as an example, it works quite well. Here we have the same deck of cards as in the insertion sort video. This time, we put all cards face up on the table. Now we look for the smallest card in the deck, which is the 2. We pick it up to the left of the hand. Then we look for the second smallest card, which is the 3. We pick it up to the right of the 2. And so it goes on. The next larger card is the 4, which we place next to the 3. Next we select the 6, the 7, and finally the 10. Let me repeat that last sentence. Next we select the 6, the 7, and finally the 10. This means we sort by selection, therefore the name selection sort. Let's switch from our example to the representation within a computer. Instead of a deck of cards, there is an array containing the elements to be sorted, in this case the numbers according to the card example. We split the array into a left part, which contains the already sorted elements, this is still empty, and a right part, which contains the unsorted elements. Now we look for the smallest element in the unsorted part. To do this, we start at the very left and remember the 6 as the smallest element for the time being. Then we go to the next element and check if it is smaller. The 2 is smaller, so we remember it as the new smallest element. We continue to the end of the array to see if it contains an even smaller element. This is not the case, so we know the 2 is smallest, and we swap it with the first element of the right part. Now we move the border between sorted and unsorted area one position to the right and repeat the process. This means we search for the smallest element in the right unsorted area again. We remember the first element, the 6, go on to the 4, compare it with the 6. The 4 is smaller, so now the 4 is our smallest element. We move further over the array to see if we can find an even smaller element. We find it here with the 3. And one last step, the 7 is not smaller, so the 3 remains our smallest element. We swap this again with the first element, that is, the 3 with the 6. And we move the border between the areas one position to the right again. Again, we look for the smallest element in the list on the right. We start with the 4. Walk over the array in search of a smaller element. We don't find one, so the 4 is smallest and belongs at the beginning of the right part. Since it is already there, we do not need to swap elements in this step. I'm gonna go a little faster. Again, we look for the smallest element, that is the 6. Which we swap with the first element of the right part, the 10. Of the remaining two elements, the 7 is the smallest, which we exchange with the 10. And now there's only one element left, which is automatically the largest and in the right place. The numbers are now sorted. That was the selection sort algorithm. You can also find it on my blog, which is linked in the video description. Let's continue with the time complexity. We denote by n the number of elements to be sorted. In our example, n equals 6. With selection sort, the actual effort lies in searching for the smallest element in the right part of the array. In the first step, we have to do 5 comparison operations to find the smallest element. In the second step, we have to do 4 comparisons. In the third step, 3, in the fourth, 2, 1 in the fifth, and none in the sixth. It doesn't matter whether the elements are already sorted or not. To find the smallest element, we have to search the entire remaining right part in each step. In total, we arrive at 15 comparison operations. We can also calculate that 6 elements times 5 steps divided by 2, since on average half of the elements are searched. 6 times 5 is 30, divided by 2 is 15. If we replace 6 by n, we get n times n minus 1 in parentheses times 1/2. In math class, we'd have to multiply that out now. We'll spare ourselves that at this point. It is enough for us to see that the term contains n times n. Therefore, in the final term, n squared. That means the time complexity of selection sort is order n squared, and that in the average, best, and worst case. Order n squared is also known as quadratic time, and that means the time needed to sort a list of elements grows proportional with the squared number of elements. When deriving the time complexity, we have considered only the comparison operations. But what about the swapping operations? In each step, we swapped exactly one element, unless the smallest element was already on the left of the unsorted part, as with the 4 in our example. So we have n minus 1 swap operations at most. This means that even if the swap operation is significantly more expensive than the comparison, if n is sufficiently high, the swap operation will no longer be relevant. Therefore, it is not taken into account in the time complexity notation. Here's an example for selection sort. For 100,000 elements, selection sort takes about 1.25 seconds on my 2019 laptop. For 100 million elements, that is 1,000 times as many, it would not take 1,000 times as long, but 1 million times as long. That would be 347 hours. For 1 billion elements, it would be almost 4 years. On the same hardware, Quicksort manages 100 million elements in 8 seconds and a billion elements in a minute and a half. But more on that in another video. And that's it for selection sort. I hope this video helped you understand how selection sort works and how its time complexity is derived. You can read all about selection sort and other sorting algorithms, including source codes, on happycoders.eu. You'll find a link in the video description. If you like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel right away. That way, you'll make sure you don't miss new sorting algorithm videos. Just click on the subscribe button below this video. And if you're interested in more how-tos and tutorials on Java algorithms and data structures, go to happycoders.eu and sign up to my newsletter. And finally, a question for you. Which sorting algorithm would you like me to explain next? Bubble sort, quick sort, merge sort, or another? Leave me a comment. See you soon and happy coding!